Chapter 5, Dive Time. Congratulations! You have taken the first step to becoming a scuba diver. Whether you plan to snorkel, shore dive, or deep sea dive, you now have the basic tools you need to start your adventure. Diving is a wonderful and rewarding sport and hobby. It's also a good profession for those interested in training, EMS, or rescue services, or those that have an interest in working with the Coast Guard or other military agencies. Most people listening to this audio will plan to dive for leisure. Make sure you enjoy yourself, follow the guidelines in this audio, and you will find diving much more enjoyable than you ever thought possible. Oh, before we leave, here are some key points to take away from this guide. Diving is exciting and fun, but it's not a sport for everyone. We recommend you try snorkeling first, see if you like it, and then progress to a beginner-level diving course. That way, if you find you don't enjoy diving, you're not going to lose tons of money in the process. Diving is a wonderful way to explore marine life. You can improve your diving adventures through note-taking and underwater photography. There is no end to the ways you can expand your experiences with diving. If you plan to dive, you should always invest in a training and certification course. Longer courses are always better than shorter ones because they allow more time for practice and teach important safety information. Be wary of resorts that offer dive certification. If you plan to take one of these courses, make sure you verify the credentials of the person teaching you to dive. Never dive alone if you plan to dive on vacation and have limited knowledge of diving. You should always dive with an experienced professional in this environment. Know your hand signals. The best way to learn these is through a proper training course. If you don't learn what signals to use, ask. They may save your life. Remember to plan your trip ahead of time. Let others know where you plan to dive and how long you expect to be gone each time. This will greatly help protect you because others know your whereabouts and they'll be the first to know if something goes awry. Find out who to contact in the event of an emergency, especially when diving abroad. Having a list of two or more providers in case you are not able to reach someone. You can also contact local Coast Guard authorities to help in the event of a search and rescue. Invest in traveler's insurance that covers diving, because diving is a dangerous sport, or it can be. Many insurance providers don't cover diving accidents specifically. Call your agent. Find out. If you do not have diver's insurance, you can buy permanent or temporary packages. Review the listings in the resources section for more information. Do not even buy the most expensive equipment you can get before you spend much time diving. Sure, the $15,000 rebreather Supreme looks great, but do you really need it? Not if you're starting out. You really don't. You should always rent equipment first, and then buy equipment when you know you're going to dive more than once or twice. When you do buy equipment, keep in mind, you don't have to buy the most expensive equipment to get the best equipment. Visit multiple dive centers and shops and ask someone you trust, like your trainer, their opinion of equipment before diving. Buy a cheap disposable camera to take underwater pictures while you learn to dive. There's no sense spending hundreds of dollars unless you plan to be a professional photographer or make a serious sport or hobby of it. If you do, you should take underwater photography classes as well as diving classes. Decide your goals ahead of time. That way, you will enjoy your time and won't suffer disappointment. Remember to plan fun into your adventure, whether diving for sport, work, or fun. Never, ever panic, because you may find you face a much more serious emergency if you do panic. Relax. Take a deep breath. Follow any emergency procedures taught to you during your training sessions. Never dive alone. Even if experienced, you always need a helping hand. Check out the local weather before diving. You don't even want to dive during inclement weather, as this can increase your risk for an emergency. Avoid night diving unless you receive advanced training. It's hard enough to see when deep sea diving during the daylight. Only experienced divers should try night diving. Storms are almost more likely in the evenings, and as mentioned earlier, it's always best to dive during good weather. Make sure you get a good night's sleep before diving. When you feel well rested, you are more likely to remain calm in emergencies and learn more when engaging in training sessions. Do your homework. Find places to dive that have interesting marine life. You don't want to spend weeks training only to visit a region that has nothing to view underwater but seashells, after all, do you? Last but not least, have fun. diving is one of the more adventurous and rewarding sports and hobbies available to humans. When you take proper precautions, you may find scuba the most enjoyable experience of your life.